Hey guys, welcome back to World of Tanks. My name is Bruce and today I want to talk about the most enjoyable tank in my garage, the AMX 1357. If you're interested in more reviews and gameplay, go to YouTube and search for World of Tanks with Bruce to get all of my videos, or click on the subscribe button and now let's go. Before we start with some gameplay, let's quickly compare the AMX 1357 against its counterpart, the AMX 1375, which is the Tech Tree Tier 7 light tank. And as you can see, the DPM is much better on the AMX 1357. It has basically the same penetration. It does have only 90 alpha damage, however, it does have 8 shots in its autoloader clip instead of only 4, and so it can deal 720 damage within 70 seconds instead of 540 within 6 seconds. So yeah, only having 1 second of intra clip reload is quite a good thing and makes this tank much better. Now the gun handling is slightly worse, at least compared to, or at least talking about the aim time, 2.21 seconds against 1.92. However, the rest of the gun stats are better compared to the regular Tech Tree tank. Now mobility is approximately the same. It has a little bit less engine power, but that's how it is, no problem at all. And then talking about the view range, it is again much better, 390 compared to 370. So having the same camouflage value, the MX 1357 is just the better spotter compared to the regular Tech Tree tank. So in my opinion, this is another version of pay to win from Wargaming, producing a premium tank which is in the end so much better compared to the regular Tech Tree tank. Now, how do I play this tank? As you can see, I inserted a very new crew. I used the one of my recruits in order to get a relatively nicely trained commander. So as you can see, my commander does have obviously Sixth Sense, then Brothers in Arms, then also the concealment skill, and it is working on recon. The other two crew members only have Brothers in Arms, as you can see, and they are working on concealment 97% and 99%. And so my concealment value is very nice. 40.23 is excellent. Why so? Well, because I am playing with the low noise exhaust system, which increases the concealment stationary and when moving. I obviously also use the coated optics, which is a must on, in my opinion, light tanks as well as medium tanks. And then I also use the vertical stabilizer in order to increase the gun handling, or to improve the gun handling, I should say. And then obviously, as usual, I play with a manual fire extinguisher. I play with a small repair kit and then also a small first aid kit in order to make as much credits as possible. All right, here we are in our AMX 1357, and as usual, let's take a look at the map first. Spawning on Westfield in the northeast, the situation usually looks like this, and with the light tank you have several options. You can either play in the middle right here, or you can go defensively in this position and try to spot all the tanks that are crossing like this, or you can play aggressively and move down here. However, you should be able to win a 1v1 situation against the other tanks, because the enemy light tanks might also be pushing in this direction. Also medium tanks might be pushing there. Alright, so before we start, quick assessment of the game. We are spawning on Westfield and we are in a top tier scenario, a tier 7 light tank, but with a very high firepower. And there are two light tanks in the game, there's no artillery in the game. So my decision is to go to the K0 position, because I think it is crucial for winning the left flank. And I am pretty convinced that I do have the highest firepower of all the light tanks in the game. And so I will definitely try to make pressure on this side. Now, if we take a look at the weaponry, this tank has a very, very strong DPM. 1900 for an autoloader tank is superb. The damage is abysmal, I would say. Only 90 damage, however, it does have an 8-shot autoloader clip. So it can deal 720 damage within only 7 seconds, because the intro clip reload is only 1 second. So you can really punish your enemy tanks. Now dispersion 0.35, so this gun is even very accurate. And yeah, so and the shell velocity is also fine with 1100 meters per second. So the firepower of this tank is nice, and now you can see what you can do with your gun. So you can just rip apart the enemy tanks, and as you can see, he is not managing to aim his shot, and now we can take out a whole tier 6 tank with only one clip. And yeah, this firepower is insane on tier 7. So with this tank, and this is how, this is why I enjoy this thing so much, you can just rip apart a whole enemy tank, and this can only be done by very, very few other tanks like the AMX 50-100. But this tank does have drawbacks because it's a heavy tank, it does not have any armor, and so on and so forth. Okay, now I get hit here. But this tank does not have such problems. Okay, obviously this light tank also does not have any armor. However, it is a light tank, so you can also, you don't have to rely on your firepower, but you can also just play as a regular light tank, which makes this tank, in my opinion, ultra, ultra strong. So we managed to clip our two tanks at the beginning of the game, and look how fast this gun is reloaded. Reload time of the whole clip is only 15.66 seconds stock, which is insane. As I said, 1900 DPM on a tier 7 autoloader tank. Okay, so we lost quite some hit points, but that is alright because we won this position, and now, okay, now we cannot make any damage on the T20 as it looks like. Talking about the mobility, this tank has a top speed of 61 kph. Power to weight ratio of 25.85, so it is super, super mobile, and it does have 6 degrees of gun depression only and 12 degrees of gun elevation, so this kind of is a limit here and there, but the mobility is quite good for a medium, for a light tank, sorry. Not the very best mobility, but it is okay, and I'm not using such things as, for example, a turbocharger or yeah, to increase the mobility, because I think it is okay for such a tank. Okay, so the game is won, and now we do need to move forward and make more damage. And as you can see, we are unable to penetrate the armor of the A3E2. So we need to flank our enemies. Now the first thing is we want to use obviously our view range in order to spot, and now we need to flank such a tank, and then auto aim is your friend. Use auto aim and then just clip him out. There you go. And yeah, this is how you play this tank. As you can see, the gun elevation in this case is not enough. And yeah, so what else does this tank offer? It has no armor, it has 890 hit points, which is not too much, so you obviously on tier 7 tank you need to play cautiously, but it does have 1704 stationary and also moving camo value, which is very, very strong. And my setup, I have currently 39% camo, which is also insane for a tier 7 tank. 390 meters of view range is also superb, so it is, in my opinion, a very strong light tank, and the firepower is insane. So yeah, this tank is just superior to other tanks. Now look what we can do to the Stridswagen M4. We are just ripping apart this poor little tank, and yeah, I recently bought this tank, and I have to say it is one of my favorite tanks. It is a fun tank to play. Obviously, you need to know what you are doing, but if you are a little bit experienced, then this tank is such a fun tank to play. And now here I I actually didn't recognize that I only had 3 AP shells left, so I'm loading to APCR. Now I want to clip out the IS. I think he has already shot. There you go, so I can stand just here and just clip him out. Clip him out, and yeah, because the thing was, he did not shoot. I just thought that he would have shot. And so, yeah, little mistake by myself. I should have flanked this tank, should have went around him, and then I could have clipped him out and got even more damage. However, in the end, we made 3000 damage combined with the tier 7 tank, which is a fantastic result. And yeah, a wonderful tank, really a wonderful, fun tank to play. And let's jump into the next game. Okay, second game in the AMX 1357, and as usual, let's take a look at the map. Spawning on Pearl River in the north, this is how the situation usually looks like, and with the light tank you have several options. You can play down in the south, but you can also play aggressively and try to win this portion of the map, the little town here in the center, and this offers you to spot all the southern side, so it is a very beneficial position. However, it is a very risky gameplay to go here, and so you really have to assess whether this is a real option for you at the beginning of the game. Alright, so let's assess the situation real quick here. We are spawning in a tier 8 matchup, so basically a low tier situation. There are only two other light tanks, or there are two light tanks in the game. The enemy team does have a T-71 CMCD and also an AMX 1375. So in my opinion, my tank does have the highest firepower with my 8-shot autoloader clip. Now, obviously, it is a risky move to move towards the middle. However, as it is high rewarding and as I do have the highest firepower in the amongst the light tanks, at least in the game, and the highest speed, certainly, I definitely want to make the risk and want to go for the risk and go to the middle. And the game plan is, I would push up here all the way, and then I would see if there are enemy light tanks and how many enemy light tanks are pushing here. And then the escape option is to go down here and fall back here and escape. So it looks like I'm the first one here, which is excellent. And so the next game plan is to just wait behind this little rock here and to surprise enemy tanks that are approaching here. Now it looks like the E25 had the same game plan. And looks like we both managed to go here without any enemy light tank, and so we should have an advantage. Now, if there is a light tank pushing up here, I would just try to clip him out. And, okay, here you go, that's what I mean. And I'm not even hiding, because I just want to... Here you go. Okay, go into the reload for 15 seconds, because then I will have another 720 damage that I can pump out. And now we can just... Okay, finish off the T-71 CMCD. However, I think he is escaping already. And looks like enemy tanks are moving forward, playing aggressively. However, this is a mistake, because we will be able to clip them out. Now, the problem is the T-29 is looking towards our direction, and I definitely do not want to eat a shot from him. So this is why I will definitely try to stay defensively and not peek out. I want my tanks to spot him once he's peeking out. Here you go. Now we can... Okay, looks like the King Tiger captured is moving forward. Okay, looks like he is coming towards the hill, so we need to have a game plan for this, and the game plan is to escape behind this little rock here and then to open up a crossfire situation together with the E25. Now, hopefully the E25 is going to do this, and now as you can see, so let's pause here real quick. So the E25 is shooting from this direction, and so what I need to do is I need to go here so that we can shoot on this King Tiger from different angles. So that means that if the King Tiger will turn towards the E25, then he will show the rear or the side, yeah, basically the side and the rear of his tank towards me, so I can shoot on him. Or vice versa, if he's pointing towards me, then the E25 will be able to get shots on him. So let's see if the E25 understands this game plan. Looks like the King Tiger is now turning towards the E25, which is nice. And now we need to move out and we need to clip him out. 720 damage, and off you go. Here you go. Here you go. Look at this. Look at this. Nice. Nice. And we can finish him off. This is the power of this tank, and I really adore this little 57mm gun. And yeah, thanking the E25 for his excellent game plan. Now, as the next victim, I would call. I would call it for our 8 shots, and let's see here. This is so much fun. It is just so much fun. And yeah, it's, I don't know. I just recently got this tank, and I think it's my favorite tank in the game. So I will definitely play this tank, you know, once things are not going as I would like to, then I am playing this tank and I'm just enjoying my World of Tanks. My World of Tanks games, yeah. Okay, so we want to peek out here in order to see whether we get spotted, and we do not get spotted, so we can afford to go all the way down here and help our heavy tanks in order to finish off the enemy tanks. Now, the 87 is now down to being one shot, and so we will finish him off, and then we'll load or pump out our clip into the other tanks that are standing there. So let's see, here we go. Okay, he's taken out, and now, okay, looks like this CS-52 list is AFK, but that is not a problem at all. Okay, so thanks a lot for 720 damage. Now the T-26E5 is turning towards us, but that is not a problem because we can hide. Now we just need to reload our gun, and then guess who is getting our 720 clip potential next? It is, okay, so auto aim, as you could see, auto aim in this situation does not work. So discontinue auto aim and aim at the rear side of the tank, at the engine compartment, yeah. So auto aim, as you can see, you have to make sure that auto aim really works, and the downside of auto aim is that it always focuses the center of the tank, and if the center of the tank is heavily armored, due to the shape of the tank, then auto aim will not work. Okay, so yeah, we made 2,345 damage, 618 spotting, another great result. 2,900 combined in a tier 7 tank is superb in my opinion, and this tank is just so fun to play. Okay, so I would say third and last game. All right, third and last game. We're spawning on Himmelsdorf, and once again, let's first of all take a look at the map. Spawning on Himmelsdorf in the north, the situation looks like this, and Himmelsdorf is definitely not the preferred option for a light tank. But with the AMX 1357, you can still play on Himmelsdorf because of your insane autoloader clip. And in my opinion, it is beneficial to maybe go to the middle and get a first spot on the enemy team, or go to the 1 and 2 lane and maybe go here to play defensively, or situationally dependent, also push here and play a little bit more aggressively. Okay, so that is exactly what we are going to do. We will try to play on the right hand flank. Now, as you can see, we are in a top tier situation, in a tier 5 to tier 7 matchup, so our firepower is just so much better than compared to the tier 5 tanks, and we'll be able to rip apart one or the other tank. Okay, so there's one thing that you need to keep in mind with the AMX 1357. We talked about the weaponry. The intra clip reload is only 1 second, but the aim time is 2.21 second. But my opinion is that this is not too much of a problem, because the circle just does not bloom out as much as on other tanks, because yeah, that's just how it is, and it doesn't hinder you to pump out your damage with the one shot intra clip reload, even if you are shooting at a further distance. So in my opinion, this this autoloader gun is relatively strong, and maybe one thing that holds this tank a little bit back is the low penetration of 143mm, which is enough on tier 7, but which is of course always enough if you are flanking your enemies, and that is what you are supposed to do in your AMX 1357. However, frontally against tier 8 tanks, it is not not enough. But then you can also always switch to your APCR shells and just use the premium shells with the increased penetration. Now, here you go. We are making 370 damage to the Churchill. 370 damage just because we only had half of our clip. But this, even this is insane on tier 7 for line tech. And now we even, okay, we light him up. But he is, he remains with his 2 hit points. Okay, so 634 damage, and now, yep, looks like the Panther is playing aggressively, and our 143 millimeters of penetration should be enough to, okay, to even frontally penetrate him, which is nice. Okay, here you go, and as you can see, let's strike him. Oh, you know what, let's make damage, here you go, and we can finish him off. Excellent. This tank is just so much fun to play, and even in a city map, as you can see, you are able to make your damage. Now, my game plan is to flank the 88. Looks like the game is already won, which is nice. However, we want to make more damage, and let's see whether we are able to flank the 88. Now, obviously, I want to move in aggressively because I do have hit points to trade, and the game is about to be at the end, so I'm spotted, and of course the tank will turn towards me. That is all right. So let's finish off the Churchill first. Here you go, and now it is time to clip him out. Here you go. Okay, as you can see, the angle does not need to be too great, so just clipping this tank destroyer out. Yeah, I cannot stress this enough. This tank is so much fun to play. And in my opinion, a superb light tank, even without its autoloader gun. But the autoloader gun is what is so enjoyable about this tank. Oh, let's finish him off. And let's finish off this guy here. And yeah, I mean, against tier 5 tanks and tier 6 tanks, it's just insane. It is just insane. So, do we get some more damage here on the Panzer 3-4? Nope. So yeah, in this game we made 1650 damage on a city map. So even if you're playing on a city map with this tank, you will be able to have fun and enjoy your games. So overall, yeah, I really do like this tank, and I think it is a very, very good choice. It is not as expensive as tier 8 tanks, but it is fun to play. You can make lots of credits because you don't have to rely on the damage output, which is insane, as you could see in the 3 videos. But you can also just play it as a light tank and make your credits with spotting. So in my opinion, a very, very decent choice, the MX-1357. Alright guys, that was it for today with the MX-1357. What is your opinion about this tank? Do you think it is overpowered? Do you like this kind of autoloader, or do you detest 90 alpha damage on tier 7? Just leave a comment in the comment section down below. If you liked the video, give it a thumbs up. If you hated it, give it a thumbs down. Consider subscribing to my channel, and I see you next time in another World of Tanks video.